Ocean Coast and Babyhead were having a management battle. Who's going to headline it? They didn't want it because they want us to go on last. We didn't want it because we want them to go on last.
Okay? Why was that?
Because we wanted to blow them off stage and they wanted to blow up us off stage, like when the Sly and the Family Stone went on before the Who at Woodstock. So we let them go on. So our lead singer, to really pull out the stops, wears a red jumper from Next.
Totally take over. It's my jumper.
Is it? Oh.
Are we in the right place?
Yeah.
Please help.
Remember this one?
Rings a bell,
isn't
it?
Oh, it's a mortgage, this one.
Thanks for this
floral shop.
My pleasure.
Right, so here on the Hoxton Radio Show, we've got Damon Minchella in the house. And Tony Briggs.
How are you doing?
Yeah, my record collection is just what I take the pictures of, just based on the photography, so it's very limited. Mostly Ocean Coast.
Well, talking of pictures then, let me pick a picture out of this book. But where can people buy it, Tony, now?
That's a good question. Online is probably the cheapest, best deal from Countdown.
Countdown
the
books.
Publishers, yeah.
Cool.
Actually, all the photos I've got in my loft are far better than these. I'm going to pick one out at random, which kind of sums up the band, and it's in Madrid. And this sums up Ocean Colours at this point. So, you've got my dad at the back, and there's me with him, and we're talking about the tapas we've just had. We've got a security guy called Ian McAllister, who, after this talk, gave up looking after bands. We've got Oscar, who's been drinking milk. Steve Craddock, who is so drunk, he's actually lost his shoes.
One shoe and a shirt off, is it?
Yeah.
So the shirt off, is it?
And we have been thrown out of the restaurant because he's so drunk. Bear in mind, you're in a suburb in Madrid and no one else is in the restaurant.
Midday. It's about midday.
Geeked four people at Manchester.
Yeah.
10 minutes before we go on stage, there's no one in there.
Yeah.
I mean, no one.
Right.
Not even bar staff. Let's pull it. And last minute, we thought, oh, sod it. We've come all the way from Birmingham to Manchester. We just play. So he turns up a minute before we go and we play, and then we get a review saying the band the Beatles should have been, Stone Roses nearly were, and the one that the Lars wanted. Right. We've got to do them. So God bless Bob's today.
Green Onions and Noel Gallagher.
Oh, that was Electric Ballroom.
Oh, right.
Dave Chipper and Noel was like, we're just about to go on stage. Green Onions is going, he said, what are you going to start with? He said, Riverboat, he said, you can't start with your best tune. He said, we're not going
to. Boom. So,
the best review Ocean Cousin ever had, actually, in The Enemy, was they were reviewing 100 Mile High City, which you just played, and they said, this is the owl equivalent of a potato. And the lead singer puts the no one into Peter Noon, who was the lead singer of Herman's Hermit. It's like the worst band in the 60s ever. I thought, that's really funny, because a month later, we did the front cover for them.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we were selling a million records, and they were selling 30,000.
Right. So we got the next track is Eddie Kendricks. So tell us a bit about
this. Oh, my God, I love Eddie Kendricks. Right, this is down to Marco Nelson, who was... played bass in the Star Council for a short while. He was in Young Disciples, who made one record called Road to Freedom, possibly the greatest record you have never heard, listeners.
Right.
That was 1992. They recorded it at Weller's studio called Solid Bond, which is the last place that Frank Sinatra and Scott Walker ever sang when they were recorded. Signed to Fontana Records. Ocean Gutting were doing their first record there.
Right.
Met Brendan Lynch, met Paul Weller, met Marco. Talking to Marco, he said, a few years later, you've got to listen to Eddie Kendricks. Okay? There's a tune called Girl, You Need a Change of Mind, which was released in 1974, which invented house music. Lastly, just a bit of self-promotion, even though it's not for me, Glass City Vice will be on the website, their new tune, check it.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That's what music needs. It needs people who care about it to pull it out of the trough of it's a commodity, because music is an art form, and that's why Gig Stops is great, because the people here love music.
Yeah.
Good night.
Right on. See you later.
Thank you, man. Good.